years, but they're starting to put it together. Series record belongs to Duke, lopsided with 132 wins against 61 setbacks. And Duke, as we said, has won 13 of the last 14. But can Wake Forest pull off what they pulled off a couple of years ago? We're about to find out.
One of the things that you have to be concerned about if you're Dave Odom, Duke had a 17-4 run against his team in the first half of the last game. You'd really like to stay close to the Duke Blue Devils to keep your home crowd involved in the basketball game. Wake opens up in a man-to-man.
And included in that 17-4 run, Dan was talking about 11 straight in the final minute and 20 seconds of the first half, and that's when the game got away from Wake Forest. They get an early break with Duke's first turnover of the ball game.
Trying to get the ball inside to Christian Laettner. Interestingly, Rogers matched up against Laettner in the man-to-man defense.
Caffrey on Seiler.
Duke, of course, in their traditional man-to-man. They really put a lot of pressure on the basketball.
Rogers down low to Tucker. Anthony Tucker puts Wake Forest in front.
Good ball movement by Wake Forest, Brad. Tucker did a nice job getting rid of Kubek.
Here's Grant Hill offensively on the other end. Kubek has become a starter again as of late. Hill inside, another turnover. Here comes Wake Forest. Anthony Tucker again on the baseline. A little bit too strong that time, and Hill will pull it off.
Duke has struggled in the half-court offense. They've tried two entry passes to exactly the same place and thrown both of them away.
Laettner for three.
Boy. We talk about a guy who's versatile. Score inside, score outside, rebounds. He leads this team in steals. What a year he's had.
Just a shade under 7 feet tall, and he just buried one from three-point land. Duke in front by one. And a whistle and a hand check foul on Hurley.
McQueen possesses pretty good quickness with the dribble. Mike Krzyzewski up talking to his basketball team. But that's a tough matchup for Hurley. And, of course, Hurley's got a lot of tough matchups in this league. You get a look at Dave Odom.
You got a spot, don't come across.
If Kenny Anderson indeed turns pro, as so many people think he will, Hurley and McQueen actually will be the elder statesman almost at point guard around the ACC next year. McCaffrey all over Seiler on the baseline.
That's good defense by McCaffrey to cut him off.
McQueen for three.
Hurley started to cheat down to the baseline to try to cut off a passing lane. Then McQueen left him, got to an open spot and scored.
Nice pass in low. Whistle before Laettner puts it up. He's fouled underneath.
We talked about the matchup. Rogers against Laettner down inside. That's a place that Duke would really like to attack. Rogers with pretty good position. That's an awfully tough pass. But Duke attacks the basket, Brad. That's why they get fouled so much. That's why they go to the free throw line so much. They attack the basket. That's a real aggressive pass inside and a great catch by Laettner.
Dave Odom wants to make very sure that Rogers doesn't get in foul trouble, so Medlin comes in. Laettner had another thought from the three-point line. Instead, leaves it off for Bobby Hurley.
Coach doesn't mind it when you shoot like Laettner, if you think about it.
There's the pass from Hurley to Laettner in low. But this time, they'll wave it off. This foul will be on King.
What this is a screen and roll. Medlin goes out and tries the double team. And Laettner just feels that there's no pressure against him, rolls to the basket. Nice job by Hurley against the double team to find the open spot.
Laettner's wondering when he can buy one here pretty soon. Keeps putting it in, keeps getting fouled, and this time looked like he walked. He did. No, he didn't. Excuse me. If he did walk, he was pushed.
You're right, Brad. He scored an awful lot of points that haven't counted here so far in the game. There's the fake as he's going to the basket. Get a push right there. See, Laettner, he wants the basket to be good. So far, they've called all of those on the drive rather than on the shot. If you're Laettner, you don't want to use them up. And if you're Dave Odom, you're not very happy at this point.
Laettner alone would have about a one-point lead over Wake Forest if any of these baskets would be counting right now. Grant Hill outside. Too strong. Pulled off by McQueen. 5-3, Wake Forest early. Chris King. Seiler tips it, keeps it alive. Tucker had it blocked by Kubek. But he stepped out of bounds.
Don't often see Duke do such a poor job on the block out.
Seiler got loose on the inbounds, and he's hammered by Laettner.
I think they're actually going to call Kubek for the foul. Yeah, the foul's going to be called against Greg Kubek. We talked about how when you attack the basket, that's what creates fouling situation. Boy, Seiler really gets up, takes it right at Laettner, but Kubek fouled him going by.
Take your pick. They both almost took his shoulder off, so Seiler will go to the free throw line.
Seiler got up in the air big time there, though, Brad.
He gets a mile high despite a bad knee that has been surgically repaired a couple of times. And I talked to him before the game. He's playing with a brace that doesn't fit quite right, and it's caused some discomfort over the last couple of games. But ACC, despite that bad wheel, and he hits both free throws, and Wake Forest is out in front by four.
Thus far, Brad, Wake Forest has done a nice job making Duke play offense against their set half-court defense.
Here's
and when you
steal.
Play against the set half-court
call. Didn't go where Chris King thought he was headed. First turnover against Wake Forest.
You know, interestingly enough, Brad, in that first game where Wake Forest turned the ball over 23 times, 14 of those turnovers came from Tucker, from King, or from Medlin. So it's not Derek McQueen that's thrown it out of bounds, and that's a very difficult play for a big guy to make in the middle, and King didn't make it well. Now we've got something on the court.
So they whistle the action to a halt. Meanwhile, Childress is going to check in for Rogers.
You talk about a spark off the bench. Mr. Childress, certain classic guy. Contact lens, I think.
Robert Seiler with a contact lens problem. So they're going to have him get that back in, I'm sure, in a hurry, because he has 4 points to lead Wake in scoring. Another whistle and a foul on Medlin, who's trying to hang with Christian Laettner. Not too many people can do that.
Certainly not an easy task, and to this point in the ball game, Brad, I'm very impressed with the kind of defense that Wake Forest is playing out there. They're playing good, hard-nosed physical defense, but so far they haven't really allowed much penetration of their defense, so it's made the entry passes inside very difficult for Duke.
It appears Dave Odom has come in with the theory that he's going to keep switching Medlin and Rogers off just to try to control. Laettner, and Hurley hits a three outside.
Talked about how Duke's perimeter game has really come around as the season's progressed. They've only scored two field goals, but they're both three-pointers. Even though they haven't played particularly well offensively to date, in this ball game, they're still within three.
Bobby Hurley with 49 three-pointers on the season. Entry pass almost stolen away by Kubek. Childress will try it again on top with Thomas Hill on him.
Well, that's good defense by Hill.
King got Laettner up. Laettner struggled back to almost get a piece of that. Tucker keeps it alive with a left hand. Thomas Hill picks up the foul and a chance for a three-point play. Seiler's going to check back in.
Brad, I'll tell you what we're seeing is a very aggressive group of Wake Forest Demon Deacons. It was Tucker in the middle of a pack of three Duke Blue Devils able to tip the ball up on the board and keep it alive.
Anthony Tucker with 4 points. Seiler has four. McQueen has three. That's the scoring for Wake Forest. Tucker with a couple of offensive rebounds. A chance here for a three-point play. Rebound comes off to Laettner. That's his first of the day. 11-6 Wake Forest, another turnover.
Hurley forcing it a little bit there, Brad. I think he really feels like Duke needs to get off and running. That's a walk.
Seiler turns it over. Dave Odom wanted his club to get off to a good start. They've done it. 15-10 to go first half. 11-6 Wake Forest. Back after this from our good friends at Budweiser.
basketball game. Wake Forest with the lead, and one way they've done it is off the offensive boards. There's a great tip by Rogers inside in the middle of the Blue Devils. Tucker's able to control it, get it in the basket. Three offensive rebounds for Wake Forest early. Offensive rebounds are positioning and work. And Wake Forest working very hard early in the basketball game.
There's the turnover story. Both teams shooting 50%, but obviously Wake has shot more times. As Duke has turned it over several occasions.
1-3-1 zone for Wake Forest coming out of that timeout as Dave Odom just looks to change the tempo slightly.
Kubek outside. Three-pointer.
Brad, they've only scored three field goals, but they've all been three-pointers. One by Laettner, one by Hurley, and now Kubek.
Lead cut down to two. Rogers drives on Laettner. Leaves it off Tucker, who's been a big part of the offense. 6 points for Tucker. Again, the lead is four.
That's a nice looking move against some pretty good pressure. Back to the man-to-man defense now. They'll go to Wake Forest Demon Deacons. Just use that 1-3-1, one trip down the court.
Here's the offense off the bench for Duke. In and out. On Hill's first shot, Tucker the rebound. Boy, Tucker is playing great early. His third rebound to go with 6 points. Childress.
He's out of bounds.
Well, three-pointer's one thing, but you can't be over by the other team's bench.
Well, you like to create that space between you and the defense.
We saw him shoot one here Sunday from right in front of the Wake bench that was in about the same spot. Had no business putting it up, but he was fouled, and he hit all the free throws. So.
Well, he was over there by Mike Krzyzewski, and he knows that Mike doesn't play defense as well as he used to, so I figured that was a good spot.
13-9. Wake Forest, the four-point lead with 14 minutes to go first half.
Again, the Wake Forest defense has done a great job keeping Duke on the perimeter. The Childress there cuts off Hurley's penetration.
King now playing on Laettner. They've switched off three times on Laettner, so he just drills it from outside. That's a two-pointer, the first two-point field goal of the game for Duke.
And still, Duke hasn't scored a basket from anywhere close.
Rogers weaves his way and had it goaltended by Davis.
That ought to be illegal for a guy like that. Watch this. Switches hands with the basketball, drives in, lays it up with left. Obviously, that's a goaltend. What a nice move. Just goes right by the defense out on the top and then through a pretty tough help defense by the Duke Blue Devils.
Wake Forest lead is four. North Carolina a winner today, as was Virginia. Hurley misses outside. Laettner, the offensive rebound, leans in off the glass. Seven for Laettner. Cuts the lead to two again.
It's going to be hard to keep him under control on the interior the whole game. He just gave notice that he's going to be a presence inside.
Seiler drives the paint, left-hander, no good, and a charging call against Seiler.
And you want to know what was the most impressive thing about that last move by Rogers, the last trip down the court, is that he was able to penetrate and get to the basket and score. Seiler, who's a guard, wasn't able to accomplish it.
Point.
Because Laettner stepped in and took the charge.
Laettner will get a breather. Antonio Lang, another freshman parade All-American, checks in.
Of course, Seiler's a little smaller than Rogers, so it's easier to work up the nerve to step in front of him for the charge.
Hurley, Davis, Lang, Palmer, and Hill out there for Duke right now. Between Seiler, Rogers, King, and Tucker for Wake Forest. Out of room on the baseline is Hill. He kicks it out to Davis. And Davis has the jumper outside. His first score. Tie game. First tie of the ball game. McQueen around a pick. Alone is Rogers. Three-pointer. Tucker, another offensive rebound. And he's fouled going up. Three offensive rebounds here in the first 7.5 minutes.
Tucker makes a very good play. He's going to set a screen, and he's going to pick off Hurley, and then he's just going to go to the basket. See, Bobby Hurley's man, Brian Davis, switched out on the shooter, and as a result, Hurley's got to go pick up Tucker. When he doesn't, there's nobody there to block him out.
Tucker missed his first free throw, leading Wake Forest, though, with 6 points, and again, he rattles one around.
Now, if I'm Hurley, I don't want to be down inside with Tucker, but he's really got to go with him to block him out.
Tucker's menacing look alone is enough to make you want to clear out of the way. Seven for Anthony. The lead all scores. along with Laettner, who also has seven.
See, when little guys get down inside to block out, Brent, if they get a block out and the big guy jumps over them, officials really like to call fouls on the big guys in that situation. It's sort of sympathy foul.
That does tend to happen.
You're not going to get the sympathy foul standing out the top of the key watching the guy who you're supposed to be guarding get a rebound.
We're under 12 minutes, and Wake Forest maintains a one-point lead. Early around Palmer's pick, and he is fouled by Rogers. Rogers doesn't want to get a cheap foul way out there, 30 feet.
No, you're absolutely right. If Rogers is going to get fouls, and that's now two against Rogers, and Dave Odom knows it, Rogers has got to get his fouls against Christian Laettner, not fouling Bobby Hurley 30 feet from the hoop.
11:48 to go first half, and the hometown Demon Deacons holding on to a one-point edge.
Game, the Duke Blue Devils hanging in there, and the reason is Wake Forest has done a great job with inside defense. That's a great job to cut off the penetration, but then Thomas Hill maintains his composure, makes a very good pass, and the Blue Devils score from the perimeter.
I think if somebody would have told Dave Odom before the game, hey, we'll work our way down to the 12-minute mark, you can have the lead in the first half, he would have taken that to start the game. Now it's a matter of maintaining or stretching the lead.
What coaches will take before it starts is always different, and they always get greedy once they go.
That's true. Duke can regain the lead if Hurley hits his three. Rebound.
Owens, what a great block out by Owens and Wise to get that rebound.
Kalani Owens, another freshman. Here he is on the offensive end. We've got a foul inside. Be sure to stay tuned at halftime for the Norwegian Cruise Lines Trivia Contest. You could win a great cruise for two. That's coming up halftime here from Winston-Salem.
Fouls against Antonio Lang. This is a very interesting stretch for Wake Forest. They've got sort of an odd lineup in the game. Owens and Wise, not noted as offensive players, are in the basketball game. So the other three guys in for the Demon Deacons are really going to have to take over the scoring role.
Scoring has been McQueen 3, Siler 4, Childress. Three is first, and it's three, as you might expect. That's his 51st three-pointer of the year.
He was the ACC Player of the Week last week, as well as he should have been. He had a great week, some big games against Georgia Tech and Virginia.
Davis, pretty nice-looking drive. Rebound, Hill fighting with Childress, who won that battle. It'll be Wake Forest ball. Laettner McCaffrey will check back in for Duke. It's early. His first rest, and Lang will sit down as well. For Wake Forest, Chris King, who I said before the game, is Chris, you're the old man of this group. He says, yeah, I am, aren't I? And he is only a junior, Chris King, 6'8 junior.
The old man of the group is the fellow you can see at the bottom of your screen running up the court now, Tom Wise. Tom looks like he's recovering from another black eye, Brad. He's really the Chuck Leffner of the ACC.
Childress can't get that one. Hill, a great rebound.
What they call Wepner, the Bayonne
the
leader.
Bayonne
well, poor
leader.
Tom Wise, he's got none of the black eyes and broken noses to show for his effort.
McQueen fouls McCaffrey on the other end. That's the first foul on Derek McQueen. And now Wake Forest over the limit.
McQueen's upset. He's chewing on his shirt there.
Derek McQueen, who has not scored that much recently, but his assist to turnover ratio has been great. Thomas Hill will sit down.
Again, Brad, as you see Siler coming in the basketball game, ratios, and they usually emphasize the point guard. Well, the point guard, if he's a good guard, and McQueen is not really going to be turning the ball over that much. When you have problems with turnovers, it's usually your big guys who are throwing it out the door.
That's what Wake Forest did back in mid-January. McCaffrey, one of the better free throw shooters in the ACC, just under 89% coming in. And Bill got them both, his first 2 points of the game. 19-17, Wake Forest by.
Now what?
Childress and McCaffrey get all tangled up. And Lenny Wirtz splits him up. Foul will be on McCaffrey.
Mike Krzyzewski and Dave Odom wondering if it's the WWF or are we playing basketball?
The backcourt pressure now by Duke. They don't want Owens handling it. Childress now.
He can handle it if he's going to do that with it. Draw the double team and then give it to Childress. Childress throws it away.
Fifth turnover on Wake Forest. And Grant Hill now brings it up for Duke. A little more size at the point guard spot for the Blue Devil. Double team on Hill.
Great job to back out of that double team.
Laettner works in the paint. Nice move. Didn't get the shot, though. Trelawney Owens has another defensive rebound, and here he comes. Seiler kicks it back out. Childress might take it from there. He was open.
Dave Odom was not particularly enamored with that pass.
Seiler for three.
And they changed his mind after that shot, though. He got McQueen up and stuck him in the ball game.
5-point Wake Forest lead. And a whistle on the other end as Wise fouls Laettner. At least Laettner's drawing fouls from everybody, that's for sure. Duke leading the ACC, not only with their 8-2 record, but these are the reasons why.
That's the old chicken and the egg, Brad. They're at the top of the ACC, and they lead in those things. It'd be very hard to be at the bottom of the league if you lead in all those categories.
Over a 13-point difference on their opponents in scoring. Laettner's drawn 5 fouls in the game. And here he is at the free throw line for the first time. Laettner actually off his free throw percentage of last year when he led the conference, almost 84%. He's at about 78% coming into this one. 8 points for Laettner. Christian Laettner hits them both. And that cuts it to 22-19. We've experienced some audio problems during the opening moments of this game. We apologize for that. We think we've got everything squared away here in Winston-Salem now. Brad Nessler and Dan Bonner with you with 9:35 to go in the first half. And Wake Forest turns the ball over.
If you wanted to take that sequence, Brad, and put it on tape and go and show it for basketball camps in the summertime,
you'd want to burn it,
great
probably.
Defense is. That was a tremendous defensive sequence right there by the Duke Blue Devils.
And if you wanted to show it for an offensive film session, that's when you burn it.
That's right, exactly what you don't want to do.
Hill works his way for a little 12-footer. And Brad Hill's on the scoreboard for the first time. 22-21, the lead cut down to a point.
You mentioned his size at point guard, Brad. It allows him to back in and shoot over his defender. That's a very nice play.
Owens works against Laettner, stripped it away.
Don't have a lot of time to operate inside, because if you're going to try to juke and move, somebody's going to come and help. There's a foul against Brian Hill on McQueen's penetration. The basket won't count. Owens is going to learn, though. If you get the ball inside, you got to do something with it quickly, because the defense is going to collapse on it.
One-on-one situation now. The seventh team foul on Mike Krzyzewski's Blue Devils. Dave Odom will watch Derek McQueen shoot free throws. And free throws killed Wake Forest the first time these clubs got together. They were only 7 out of 12 from the line, while Duke went 22 of 25. So free throws a big difference in the first game. Now the rematch already. Wake Forest has missed a couple. Now they've missed a third. 3 out of 6 here in the first half. Gotta hit the free throw. Caffrey, jumper over McQueen. Rooms out. Tucker ahead to Seiler. 3-on-1. Chris King finishes things off.
What a great outlet pass to get that break started.
Seiler with the nice dish. And again, it's a 4-point, negative 3-point Wake Forest lead. Laettner. Partially blocked, it still went in.
Got to bring some help if Leitner's going to catch the ball down inside against a much smaller Trelawney Owens. The help didn't get there in time.
Laettner in double figures already. So what else is new, right? King, Seiler, just inside the three-point line. Davis got the rebound. Lost the handle, did Grant Hill. Last touch by Hill.
That's a great play by Grant Hill to save a basket, because if he doesn't knock that ball out of bounds, Tucker picks it up and dunks it. Mike Krzyzewski, maybe not satisfied with the results so far, but has to be satisfied with that particular effort by Grant Hill. That saved a basket.
Wake Forest by 1 with 8:04 to go. Great pass into King. Chris King has Wake Forest's last couple of baskets. Student body Huff and Mokel for Wake Forest. Steal by Tucker. He'll take it the distance.
Brad, the last two times down the court for Wake Forest, the perfect indication of what's going on. The Demon Deacons are just getting easier shots. They're getting dunks. Duke's having to shoot jumper.
Almost another steal, and then McCaffrey comes free on a switch off and buries a three.
Of course, they're hitting those jumpers, and if you hit them from three-point range, it helps.
Well, there's Chris King flying in on the wing. Wake by four.
Another very easy basket. The Duke defense not playing well the last couple of trips.
Kubek open. Duke burying those jumpers outside. Kubek's got five. It's a two-point game.
And both teams are going to get warned about playing around with the basketball after it goes through the hoop.
Wake on that little stretch there got a little bit showboaty. I don't know if I stick it in Duke's face at this point. I think I wait till about 5 seconds left in the game.
With a 15-point lead.
Right.
But the delay of game warning now issued, so when one of those warnings is issued, it's issued to both teams. So anybody else who takes the ball and pitches it aside.
Well, we've got a delay in our game. We can take a break. We'll be back after this from our friends at Budweiser.
Man, what a day. I can sure use a vacation.
Yeah, I'd like to be right here.
Ice cold, Bud.
Hey, maybe tomorrow we should bring the boss.
Nah.
When Teddy and I first started out in the toy business, we chose Nationwide Business Insurance. Now, we worked hard. And as we grew, a lot of other people gave us their opinions of our insurance plan. But none of them ever had a better second opinion than Nationwide Insurance. With Nationwide Insurance, there are no surprises. And the business without surprises is a real peaceable kingdom.
Nationwide is on your side.
When creating the new G20 midsize luxury sedan from Infiniti, these were just a few of the amenities we kept in mind. Seating surfaces that are fitted with leather, a cabin that heightens the level of comfort and stretches the limits of space. Of course, with 16 valves and 140 horsepower, that mind also has an alter ego.
Duke's trailing in this ball game by two, but you don't go to four Final Fours in 5 years unless you can get some pretty good effort from your players. Grant Hill loses the ball. What a great play to tap it out of bounds. King was going to dunk it. Now, on the inbounds pass, he did dunk it, which didn't make Mike Krzyzewski very happy, but the Deacons playing very, very well against Duke.
They've led by as many as six. Duke's lead. They had a one-point lead early, and the field goal shooting, there you take a look, that's 56% for Duke and 63% for Wake Forest.
Duke now in a 2-3 zone.
Eric McQueen looked like he wanted to handle that one for a three-point attempt. Tucker will take it outside. Medlin fights for the rebound, got it twice and still can't score. Here comes Duke. Hurley. And now Laettner, who drives in the lane, slips, goes down. Let's see. Jump ball, possession arrow to Wake Forest.
Laettner drives to the basket very well. Dave Odom's team does a nice job slapping it away from him as he puts it on the deck. That's what you're supposed to do as a guard.
Eight turnovers on Duke now, Dan.
Again, Wake Forest only has six turnovers. They've done a nice job keeping the ball away from Duke, so the Blue Devils haven't been able to get easy baskets off the defense.
Early on McQueen. Under 6 minutes to go first half. And Wake, for the most part, has led throughout. Tucker from the line. Too hard. Hurley the rebound. Bobby Hurley. Cross-courts it to Davis, who's all alone. And Derek McQueen. So the guards, the point guards, pulling down a rebound here. He's got to get rid of it. Finally does. That's a good guy to get rid of it to.
Absolutely. Rogers 2 feet from the basket. If you're going to wait a while to throw it to somebody, that's a good option to choose.
Rogers with four. The lead is four. Hill. And he's fouled by Childress. So Hill will go to the line for a couple with 5:13 to go in the half. And Wake Forest in front 32-28. Chris King checks back in. And right now, Wake Forest will have King, Tucker, Medlin, Childress, and McQueen. For Duke, it's Hurley, Davis, Crawford, Palmer, Christian Laettner, and Thomas Hill, who's set to go to the free throw line. Hill scoreless so far. You know that's going to change. He had 22 against Wake Forest a month ago. Didn't change there, though. Hill, a 6'4 sophomore at Lancaster, Texas. Averaging about 12 points a ball game. And he is in the scorebook now. 32-29, Wake by three. As we approach the 5-minute mark remaining first half here in Winston-Salem.
And Duke stays with that 2-3 zone. Got Palmer and Laettner on the inside, so the guys on the perimeter, Hill and Hurley, spreading out after the basketball. Very widely spread 2-3 zone, an active zone.
Childress is the kind of guy that can shoot you out of that zone if you can free him up. And he got his hand on it, but they threw it away.
It's interesting, Brad. Wake Forest has done a nice job not turning the ball over against the aggressive man-to-man defense, but the zone has given him a couple of problems.
That's right. The announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of Raycom and JP Sports is prohibited. Dan Bonner and Brad Nessler and Winston-Salem at Joel Coliseum, where the Demon Deacons have led for the most part of this half. Laettner missed in close. And it'll be last touch by Wake Forest.
Laettner forced that one a little bit, Brad. Dave Odom wanted his guys to collapse on Laettner. They did. Palmer was open in the middle, but Laettner forced it up there. Duke's fortunate to keep it.
Way outside is Hill. And he's got his first field goal of the day. It's a three-pointer. And now we've got another tie, 32 apiece. Second tie of the ball game.
That's 5 3-point baskets for Duke in the first half. Here's that zone again. Nobody along the baseline with the exception of King for Wake Forest against that zone.
Tucker penetrates, kicks it out to Childress. Right back to Tucker, and he's fouled by Laettner. And Laettner almost got his head taken off by his own man from behind.
Palmer really hustling in that zone, got to the corner and then got back in the middle of the zone. Mike Krzyzewski, very calm, almost pensive looking on the bench there.
Boy, he is reserved today, isn't he, so far? Siler will come back in. Derek McQueen gets a rest. And Tucker goes to the free throw line where he struggled a little bit. Hit his last one after missing his first two. But he leads Wake Forest with 9 points. And this would match what he did back in January if he hits this free throw, 10 points. And he has it now.
Saw Siler come into the game, Brad, with Childress and Siler now. The backcourt for Wake Forest gives them a little more firepower from the perimeter if Duke's going to stay in that zone.
He's well on his way as Anthony Tucker, having a better game. He's got more points and almost as many rebounds here, and we're only in the first half. 3:55 to go in the half. Wake Forest continues to lead by two.
Just a reminder that U.S. Air has more daily departures than any other airline in the free world.
For whatever you need to fix anything to do with your home, we have it all at Lowe's. When it comes to everything you need that has anything to do with your home, we have it all.
Winston-Salem, Wake Forest maintains a two-point lead with 3:55 to go. Christian Laettner leading the Duke Blue Devils attack, 11 points, and he can do it just about anywhere on the court, can't he, Dan?
The interesting thing about Christian Laettner, you see a big guy and you say, okay, he's leading the conference in field goal percentage, which he is leading the ACC, and most of the time you figure guys who are shooting the ball within 5 feet of the hoop, but Laettner, he's not that kind of a player at all. Those five outside points include 1 3-pointer and about a 16-foot jump shot. So that conference lead and field goal percentage for him, very impressive.
Laettner has 1 of 5 3-pointers for Duke. Wake Forest with 3 here in the first half. Duke can tie if they score this trip. Laettner triple team down low. Gets it back out to Hill all alone for 3.
That's called the board shot, or shooting one that's 22, 23.
Tucker got his 6th rebound, but turned it over on the other end.
And this is something that Duke hasn't had too many of, and that is a turnover that turns into a transition opportunity. Wake does a nice job getting back on defense.
And Hurley will set it at the point. We approach 3 minutes to go first half. Hurley weaves inside, had it stripped by Childress. Now stolen by Seiler and Childress. All alone is Childress.
That's a great defensive effort by Wake Forest, Brad. They're really doing the job on the defensive end, and they're turning the turnovers into easy baskets.
Medlin did a nice job behind Laettner, but he fouled him trying to slap that ball away.
Official Lenny Wirtz doesn't agree with your assessment of the job that he did.
Medlin's got 3. And Wise will check back in for him. It's the most minutes I bet Phil has played in the last few games, that's for sure. And he has been the guy that they have hoped could stop Christian Laettner. Well, he's fouled him at least. He'll send him to the line here. Laettner with 11 points. Averaging in double figures in both points and rebounds. A dozen for Laettner. He is now 7 points short of moving into the number 14 spot all time in Duke scoring. That would be Vince Taylor, who's next in line. Davis keeps it alive, and Brian Davis goes up, and down comes rebound number 7 for Anthony Tucker, who's having a monster game in the first half.
He's at least having a monster half, Brad. He's done everything that Dave Odom would like, and now Thomas Hill's going to get a foul called on him. If you're going to push the guy away, you don't do it right in front of the referee. See, now, we talked about coaches being greedy. Dave Odom wants an intentional foul. Tom Wise is a big fella. He's going to come out and set a screen right there against Thomas Hill, and you just can't push the guy away that obviously with the official standing right there watching. Mike Krzyzewski saying, hey, come on, Wise, he's a big guy. You got to push him harder than that to move.
Pretty wise move by Tom to get in the way.
Oh, don't start.
Owens comes in. King goes up. And Tom Wise, a 6'9", 240-pound senior, goes to the free throw line. Tom doesn't shoot a lot of free throws. 36-33.
Laettner really asking for the basketball.
Got it back.
Nice job by Wise. See Wise forcing the move out there. That was a really good defensive play.
Hill works free on a baseline. Wake Forest ball with 2:09 to go in the half. The fans not quite as vocal as they were against Virginia Sunday, but they know they've got a whole half left to get crazy. And boy, did they ever in the second half of that game last weekend.
That's right. They're just getting warmed up, Brad.
That's right.
They don't know how to act with Wake Forest ahead in the first half.
That's what Mike Krzyzewski's hoping, that his team's just getting warmed up. Finally, Mike's down on one knee. He had been pretty much sitting there quiet on the Duke bench, but he's involved now. Owens over Lang. Foul by Lang. Freshman on freshman there. Lang says, hey, wait a minute, I got three. I don't know if I even touched him.
Mike Krzyzewski up speaking to the officials. That's not a very good foul by Antonio Lang. Owens was actually fading away from the basket by the time he let that ball go. It was going to be about a 13-foot fadeaway jump shot. You really have to try hard not to foul that one.
Tucker, 11 points, 7 rebounds, a couple assists as he goes down and gets a breather. Antonio Lang, the only Blue Devil in foul trouble at this point.
Yo, beat his speed down there.
Jelani Owens, you're seeing more and more playing time for Wake Forest. That's his first point of the day.
As you watch him play, you can see why he's getting more time. Brad, he's a big, strong kid. He jumps well. He runs well.
Tell you what, you look at him and Rogers inside. Two freshmen who don't look or play like the freshmen. There's a foul on Chris King. As Laettner got the rebound and King took it away from him, but picks up the foul to boot.
Leitner's been fouled in the basketball game 7 times.
Tucker's going to come right back in. King will come out. Tucker with no foul, so Chris King sits down with 1:50 to go.
That was King's second foul. You don't want him to pick up his third with less than 2 minutes to go in the first half.
Christian Laettner, 3 out of 4 from the free throw line. 12 points on the day. 13 now.
As you look at Dave Odom, one of the reasons for the Wake Forest success, we've been sort of talking all around it in the first half, is Dave Odom has the luxury of being able to go to his bench and put some pretty good players in the basketball game. That's something that Wake Forest hasn't been able to do for a little while.
Everybody talks about Duke's depth and North Carolina's depth, and a lot of people now are saying in the next breath, and then there's Wake Forest that's got a little depth.
Boy, nice defense by Duke. Really turning it up into man-to-man, trying to cut off those passing lanes.
37-35, 2-point game. 1.5 to go in the half. Childress got around Laettner and then tried to feed inside as Laettner got a piece of it. Laettner forced that turnover. On the other end, can he run it down? He does in the corner. And then way back out on top to Thomas Hill. McCaffrey can't get it. Eric McQueen, another rebound.
Another adventurous series for Christian Laettner. He actually was there in position for the offensive rebound and couldn't get it, but he makes the steal, runs the court, makes the good pass.
Under a minute to go first half. McQueen picked up his dribble out high. Nice job on defense by Duke.
Good job by Childress to come and get the ball. You don't want to leave your guy out there hanging.
Wake will weave a little bit out high, using some clock, which is now run down to 15 on the shot clock, and that's the game clock in the corner of your screen, so about a 13-second difference. McQueen, jumper over Hurley.
That's a tough shot.
Laettner clears it ahead to Hurley, and now Duke will play for one, and what would be a tie game at halftime if they hit it, unless they hit a three. Let's see what Wake Forest does defensively. Seconds. Hurley for three. No good, and a whistle inside.
It's a foul against Duke. I didn't see who it was. I think Thomas Hill pushed off against Tucker. Hurley gets wide open for the three-pointer, Brad, as Tom Wise switches off and then goes back to Laettner. And the foul obviously occurred before what you saw right there. Hill pushing off on the inside.
Hill not only picks up his third, it gives Tucker a chance to extend the Wake Forest lead here before intermission. Doggett's going to come in, and let's see who comes out of the backcourt for Wake. They'll sit down Childress. At the free throw line, Anthony Tucker, who missed his first two and has hit 3 straight. He's got 11 points.
Doggett's in there for defensive purposes, but when you only get to play 2 seconds and a half, it really plays havoc with his points and rebound per game.
It does. Well, Anthony Tucker's found a little bit of a stroke now from the line after missing his first two. And if he hits this one, you can be assured Wake Forest will lead at halftime, regardless of what kind of shot Duke might be able to get off at the buzzer. Tucker's second. Got him both. Wake will lead at halftime, as they did 2 years ago when they upset Duke. Laettner almost went. So Wake Forest has led throughout the half. Duke had a one-point lead on one occasion, but then the Demon Deacons took over and are out front 39-35 at halftime. Can they upset the number five team in the country? Well, so far, they have done a great job in the half. This would have made it a one-point game as Laettner let go from midcourt and was just that short.
That's an awfully good-looking shot. That didn't really look like a throw at all.
Halftime at Winston-Salem, 39-35. Demon Deacons out in front of halftime. We'll be back with our halftime activities after this from our friends at Bud Light.
Today's ACC action is brought to you by Nationwide Insurance, Ford, Norwegian Cruise Line, Diet Pepsi, MCNB, and by Budweiser. Raycom Sports and Entertainment and JP Sports exclusive coverage of ACC basketball is brought to you by Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company, Infinity, True Value Hardware, Gillette, Buick, and by Food Lion.
For the NCNB Players of the Game Award, NCNB will contribute $1,000 to the ACC to be distributed among the member institutions under a conference-approved plan. That's the NCNB Players of the Game to be awarded near the end of our broadcast. 39-35, Wake Forest in front at halftime as we take a look at our U.S. Air halftime statistics. And boy, Wake Forest, 52%. If they keep that up, they got a real good chance.
Brad, field goal percentage is a direct result of the kind of shots that you get. We've said it before, and I'll say it again because I think it bears repeating. Wake Forest has gotten better shots. Duke with 5 3-pointers. The other thing interesting there, Duke shoots a tremendous number of free throws, far in excess of what their opponents shoot, and that 13 free throws for Wake Forest and 10 for Duke, I think, is an indication of how well Wake Forest has done keeping the ball away from the basket when they're on defense. They've limited Duke to some perimeter shooting, so Duke hasn't been able to get inside and create.
The balanced Duke scoring that we expected, they haven't gotten. Laettner's done most of the work. McCaffrey and Kubek with 5 apiece, each with a 3-pointer, as Duke ended up with 5 3-pointers in the first half. For Wake Forest, Anthony Tucker just exploded out of the blocks and played well on both ends of the court. 13 points to go with his 7 rebounds. Siler has 7. King has 6. Childress with 5. So the balanced scoring has come from Wake Forest. Second half underway, and it starts with Christian Laettner turning it over. 10th turnover against the Blue Devils.
And we mentioned that even though Laettner had 14 points in the first half, Brad, he did it against some pretty tough defense, and there was evidence again of the kind of defense that Wake Forest has been able to play against Christian Laettner.
Wake Forest hoping that 20 minutes from now of game clock, they can have an upset over the number five team in the country. Tucker lost the handle. Kubek goes after it with a vengeance, and Davis comes out of there with it. Davis will pull up. Hurley feeds Laettner. He'll take the baseline jumper. Well, he didn't cool off at halftime, did he?
He's hard to guard. You see him just move away from the basket, take that little dribble to square up, move himself further away from the basket, and then just stick the jumper.
16 for Laettner. It's a 2-point game. McQueen over Laettner. Got it. Basket's good, and a foul on Duke.
Fouls against Davis on the blockout. Mike Krzyzewski not particularly happy with the call, but it seems to me that Duke has turned up the intensity at the start of the second half, something they really needed. There's Davis going to come in. I guess the call is a push against Rogers. It was hard to tell from that particular angle.
So Wake with a bucket and the basketball.
Duke is a team that forces more than 20 turnovers a game, Brad. And if they're not going to force those turnovers, then they're really going to have a problem, because that's a big part of their offense.
There it is. They force it in that instance, and McCaffrey is fouled by McQueen. Aaron should have let him go. He was on his way to a traveling violation.
He certainly was off balance. Looked like he was going to fall down. But that's what we're talking about in terms of the turnovers creating offensive opportunities. That time, a foul is called on McQueen because he's back on his heels. It's a one-on-one situation. That's the kind of defense that Mike Krzyzewski wants to see.
Rogers sits down. Laettner misses on the other end. Davis, though, follows it. And Brian Davis, with a nice offensive rebound, has 4 points. And again, a two-point game.
Duke trying to match up in the man-to-man defense.
Seiler in low to Tucker. He was the first half big man for Wake Forest, and he picks up where he left off. He has 15. Laettner wants it, got it, over Owens, scores.
That was a great job getting position inside and then catching the ball in traffic.
King outside, Kubek all over it. Chris King's been quiet on offense until now. Four-point Wake Forest lead. McCaffrey, baseline. It's his first two-point field goal of the game.
Seen some pretty good offensive play by each team at the start of the second half. I don't think the defense is bad. If you watch Laettner against Owens, he plays off in the lane where he can.
Owens worked hard to get that to Tucker, and it paid off. Boy, he followed him all around the court, and finally Anthony got loose on a weak side, and he has 17 points.
I don't know how loose he was, Brad. There was three Duke players around him. He still got it up there.
47-43. Turnover. Great lead to Tucker. Wake Forest matches its largest lead. Duke trying to quiet the crowd and slow the Wake Forest run. Laettner's the guy that can do it. 20 for Laettner.
You know, Brad, one of the reasons that he seems to be the only guy scoring for Duke is when they're in the set half-court offense, he's their best option. They got to get out and start running. They're going to get some other people involved.
Laettner
with a foul.
With a foul on Owens. Kubek will sit. Thomas Hill in along with Hurley, Davis, McCaffrey, and Laettner. A smaller lineup for Duke. Seiler, McQueen, Tucker, Rogers, and King for Wake Forest. McCaffrey knocks it away.
Dave Odom, I think, thought about jumping up to try to catch that one, then decided against it. Mike Krzyzewski, you get the feeling, is over there trying to make some substitutions, do something to change the tempo of this basketball game. Wake Forest in the lead, and you get the feeling that even though they're only ahead by four, they're really in control of what's going on out there.
Here comes Duke back with the zone that we saw in the first half.
It worked for a little while in the first half.
King buries it. That breaks the zone in a minute.
You know, one thing that Wake Forest has done in the second half of their last couple of ACC games is shoot the ball very well. They haven't missed a shot in the second half.
Six for six. And another steal by King. King to Seiler to King.
A great defensive play by Thomas Hill. It's a four-on-two break. He takes the charge. Great play.
Larry Rose blows that one off. No basket, but still a six-point lead for Wake Forest. Matches their largest of the ball game with 15:27 to go.
Wake Forest with the six-point lead, and it could have very easily been eight. Again, some good defense by Wake Forest. Now, they're going to have a four-on-two break, and you just can't play defense any better in the four-on-two. Hill gets in the middle of the court, turns around, gets himself planted, That ball goes in the basket, but it's no good. And maybe later on in this game, that's a play that we'll look back on as something that really changed the flow of this basketball game. Good play by Thomas Hill.
McCaffrey open outside. Works for a shot that was blocked. Davis. Laettner underneath. And Laettner's foul.
That's three personal fouls against Rogers. He got the first one, then he was off down the court. Very impressive move for him to even get back in the play. McCaffrey's going to take it. Rogers blocks it, and now he's starting off down the court. Laettner keeps his spot. McQueen, what a great job to knock it away from Laettner, and Rogers sneaks back in and gets the foul call. You can see he's not happy with it. Very good toughness on the defensive end by Wake Forest.
That was quite a sequence on defense.
McQueen a little bit slow getting up. He's going to leave the basketball game. Childress is going to come in, but Wake Forest, Dave Odom can't ask him to work any harder than they've worked on the defensive end.
Eric went down hard, so he comes out. Seiler and Childress will be the Wake Forest backcourt. Laettner is 5 of 6 from the line. Now has 21 points. That matches what he did a month ago when these two teams got together.
Rogers, you saw on the bench, he's got 2 or 3 personal fouls.
Christian Laettner, 22 points in the ball game.
Duke with some full court pressure for the first time. They really surprised Childress with it.
Tucker got it ahead to King. Chris King calms things down, hands it back to Childress. We're under 15 minutes to go, and Wake Forest leads by 4.
Duke back into the man-to-man defense.
King works for a baseline jumper that comes out. Seiler and Laettner battled inside, and Seiler picks up the foul. That's his second.
Seiler went flying in there, Brad. Picked up the foul over Leitner's back.
Second foul on Seiler, and the fourth team foul of the half. Fans, be sure to look for details at Diet Pepsi displays for a chance to win ACC tournament tickets, US Air tickets, or other great prizes from your friends at Pepsi. Laettner backing in on Medlin. He wants the ball. McCaffrey will take it outside. It's short.
Now we're going to get a foul on McCaffrey.
That's his third.
McCaffrey shot the ball, and Seiler did a pretty good job getting in blockout position. Coaches tell you, always block out the shooter, but lots of times guys forget. Seiler did not, and as a result, he draws the foul, and his team gets the basketball.
14:25 to play. Wake Forest a little over 14 minutes away from what would be a gigantic upset if they can hang in. And they have trailed only once, 3-2 at the beginning of the ball game.
Duke showing some 1-3-1 pressure.
Tucker fights for his own rebound.
Wake Forest just out hustling the Duke Blue Devils the last couple of trips down the court.
Tucker a season high 21.
Duke just can't get anybody, but Laettner going in the half-court offense, Brad. Wake Forest has done a great job cutting down the penetration with the dribble.
Laettner looked down at the three-point line. I thought he was going to take it over Medlin out there. Double team on McCaffrey. Nice job on defense by Wake Forest.
Again, that double team against McCaffrey prevented his dribble penetration. There, once again, they stopped the penetration.
Hill with 10 on the shot clock, puts it in.
And that's why it's important to stop penetration.
Seiler lost the handle as McCaffrey got back there in a hurry. Boy, Wake Forest is pulling the plugs. They're certainly not playing conservative trying to hold on to this lead. I'll say that much.
It would be a little silly to play conservatively to try to hold on to a 4-point lead. Particularly with a 45-second shot clock, it'd be hard to do.
Hill comes in and Brian Davis goes out.
Hill, of course, comes into the ball game having missed some time with a hip pointer. He started the game, but I think this is his first time in the second half. He did not start the second half. Davis did.
Childress. What I meant about being not conservative is that they're not taking much time off the clock at all. They're just putting it up. 56-49, biggest lead. Medlin picks up the foul inside.
Medlin's got four fouls. Rogers has three fouls. Tom Wise is going to come in the basketball game. The committee that's been trying to guard Christian Laettner. Wise only has one foul.
...56-49, Wake Forest. Hurley has only 3 points in the game on a three-point field goal. Not a good shot on the baseline. Here comes McQueen. McQueen makes it a nine-point game. McCaffrey, he can't find it today. Laettner, nice baseline move by Laettner. He's got 24.
He can find it, though. He's really having a heck of a game, and it's a doggone good thing for Duke.
Grant Hill with a foul. If it wasn't for Laettner, this thing would be kind of ugly.
That's why you have a guy like Laettner on your team.
Christian Laettner, 24 points.
Laettner has been such a factor in the game, Brad, because Duke simply has not been able to create offense with their defense. They've had to play in the set half-court offense against the set half-court defense, and they've done a nice job taking advantage of Laettner, but nobody else is really kicking in.
Tucker has been the dominant force for Wake Forest with 21 points.
2-3 zone again for the Blue Devils.
Rogers had it blocked by Laettner. Out to Childress. New 45 on the shot clock with the 11:45 to go in the ball game.
Rogers really working against Laettner inside.
Childress has absolutely no conscience, I'll tell you that much. Missed that jumper, and Hill pulls off the rebound ahead to Hurley. And now to Laettner, but through his hands.
I don't think he ever touched it. Yeah, it's ruled that he did. Mike Krzyzewski, if you read lips, he said, no way.
Got just a fingertip on it, I think. Mike Krzyzewski doesn't like the call. It is Wake Forest ball when we come back. 11:30 to play in the ball game. As we go to our break, we get another look.
McQueen gets his hand on the ball right there. It did go through Laettner's hand, and the official obviously ruled that Laettner touched the ball. Wake Forest with a 7-point lead, and this is the kind of thing that drives coaches crazy. Does Laettner touch the ball or not? Officials rules that he does. Back to live action. Wake Forest missed an opportunity inside. Duke's got the ball back. Nobody's guarding Davis, and he wants it.
Double team on Laettner. Knocked away by Owens and Rogers.
You throw the ball inside to Laettner now. If you're Duke, you've got to get yourself in a position where you can score, because the defense really concentrating on Laettner.
Hill for three. Rogers battles and got the rebound to McQueen. Childress had it blocked by Hill. Back comes Thomas Hill. McQueen and Grant Hill, and last touch by Duke again.
Bobby Hurley electing to make the great play instead of the easy play that was available. He tried to throw the ball across court when Laettner was standing in the corner almost next to Hurley with nobody guarding it.
Chris King back in. Anthony Tucker gets a rest.
This is the same thing that Wake Forest did against Georgia Tech and Virginia. They really turned it up in the second half with their shooting.
They shot about 65-66% against Georgia Tech in the second half. They came from nine back last week to beat Virginia Sunday afternoon in a thrilling game here that had the fans on the court at the end. And boy, they'll be on the court and in the streets if they can pull off this shocker. Laettner clears it off ahead to Hurley. And again, Hurley threw it away.
Boy, Hurley is just not doing a very good job handling the basketball in the point for Duke. The couple of transition opportunities that they've had in this half, he's thrown the ball away.
That's not a normal day for Bobby right now, that's for sure.
Yeah.
Under 10 minutes to play. A 7-point Wake Forest lead. We haven't had any points in the last 2 minutes plus. Thomas Hill takes it away from Wake Forest. It's been turnover ball here the last 2.5 minutes. Davis, nice baseline reverse, doesn't get it. A foul after the rebound by Rogers on Grant Hill.
Grant Hill walks up the court after drawing the foul, but Brian Davis took the ball inside and the defense got there just in time to make him change the shot.
Stay tuned for the NCNB Players of the Game Award, brought to you by NCNB, coming up at the conclusion of our broadcast. I could vote right now, to tell you the truth. There's the turnover situation. Remember, Wake Forest, as we told you, had 15 turnovers in their upset win over Duke a couple of years ago. Earlier this year, 23 in a lopsided loss in Durham. Today, they're taking care of the ball better than their counterparts from Duke. Rogers, first basket of the second half. 9-point lead matches the largest of the day.
Owens is really going after Laettner, and that draws a whistle.
How many different guys have played on Laettner today? Owens, Medlin, Wise, Tucker at one point. King was on him once. They've had at least five guys that have played him at one point or another. And he's drawn 9 fouls, has Christian Laettner. Hill works through a double team, left it for Laettner, who had it blocked, but he's fouled by Owens.
One of the reasons that Leitner's so effective offensively, that he moves pretty well without the basketball. Now Owens loses him. If you're guarding Laettner, he's one guy you don't want to lose, and Owens finally comes in and commits the foul.
Laettner will make you pay, that's for sure. He has hit 7 of 8 free throws today, 24 points, 16 double-doubles on the season in points and rebounds coming into this game. And he has 8 rebounds here today, so he's working on another one. 25 for Christian Laettner. Robert Seiler will check back in for Wake Forest, and Derek McQueen gets a rest. Laettner, by the way, with his performance today, moving to the number 14 spot past Vince Taylor a few minutes ago. Number 14 in Duke's career scoring list. He's got now almost half of Duke's points, 26 of the 53. Did we tell you they were doing it with one guy or what? Seiler lost the handle. And now Wake Forest has turned it over 3 of the last 5 trips down court.
Duke plays that tough defense, and you're going to turn it over some against them.
60-53. 7-point Wake Forest lead. Hill tries to cut it to 5.
In the last couple of trips, there's been some guys other than Laettner who've caught the ball inside for Duke, and I'm sure Mike Krzyzewski thinks that's a good sign.
Childress goes straight ahead with it. 10 for Childress.
That's a pretty tough play against some pretty good pressure.
Laettner for 3. Oh, brother.
2 for 3 now from 3-point range.
29 for Christian Laettner. Laettner goes down hard. Took one in the chops as Rogers wheeled around. Laettner still down. Childress for 3 won't go. Seiler way up for the rebound. And here's Owens underneath. Wake Forest can't get it in close. Finally, Seiler does.
Laettner really got hit in the face. Mike Krzyzewski's out on the court, and he's going to get himself a technical if he is not careful.
Leitner's cut on the chin.
Well, I don't think he got hit in the chin. There you can see he goes down. I think he got hit in the cheek.
Laettner sits down, and it's 64-58 Wake Forest.
Of Wake Forest with a six-point lead. Not only is Laettner a versatile player, Brad, we now know that he does not have a glass jaw. There he catches it in the chin, and down he goes, but he's not down for the count. He's going to get back up here, but only after Wake Forest scores two.
There's Christian on the bench, and if you've ever had your jaw whacked as he did there, he spent the majority of that timeout, and he still is over there trying to figure out if his jaw fits together the way it used to. That'll change your eating habits a little bit.
I think he's counting his teeth to make sure they're all there as well.
64-58.
Well, with him out of the ball game, Duke really hasn't done very much on the offensive end in the half-court situation, except for what Laettner has done. So this is a big sequence coming up for the Duke Blue Devils.
This is where this guy usually goes to work, Thomas Hill. Kubek open for three. Comes out on him.
Brian Davis is going to get called for a foul, pushing off against Rodney Rogers. And Mike Krzyzewski, who for the most part has been seated on the bench, has taken his coat off now, and he's complaining that it was Rogers who committed the foul.
When Laettner hit the deck, so did Mike's sport coat. Dave Odom looking on, and his team go to 6-5 in the ACC and pull a big, big upset. That's what he's hoping for. Seiler pulls up, jumper. Thomas Hill the rebound. Kubek, that time he got it. Two-pointer for Kubek. That cuts the lead back to four. Anthony Tucker. Tucker's got 23.
Good job by King.
Hill to Davis. Nice pass and a foul underneath as Tucker went down trying to draw the charge.
Brad, it appears to me that Duke has gotten a little more active on the offensive end of the court, particularly with Laettner out of there. The guys seem to be cutting through a little bit better. That time Hill was trapped down on the baseline, but Davis makes a nice cut. There's Laettner ready to come back in the game, adjusting that jaw before he does.
Brian Davis, 4 points on the game. He'll go with his three rebounds today. His first trip to the free throw line. Davis had 15 points, 4 rebounds, and 5 assists a month ago against Wake Forest. He's been much quieter today. This again can cut the lead to four, and he does. And Laettner checks back in. So does Childress for Wake Forest.
Probably Laettner's going to be a little more careful about getting so close to Rogers when he's got the basketball.
McQueen bringing it up through traffic. Leaves it out for Tucker. He's triple teamed. Hurley knocked it away and stole it.
That's great hustle by Bobby Hurley. There were Wake Forest players closer to the ball than Hurley, but he just beat him to the ball.
And then following the steal by Hurley, McQueen picks up the foul, his third.
Dave Odom, you see, talking to Anthony Tucker. Wake Forest has played very well on the attack in transition, and you don't want to change, but you also don't want to necessarily be in a hurry.
We talked about it almost 10 minutes ago. They weren't using any clock at all, and they have kept the same pace throughout. So far, it served them rather well, but now it's a 4-point game, make it a 3-point game as Hurley has his first point of this half. Duke's been in a lot of these kind of ball games. They know what it's all about to scrap on defense and fight back into games. They're on a 13-6 run here as Hurley hits both free throws. Chris King, 1-on-3. Oh boy, he's going to take the shot.
And this Duke pressure is what's doing it. They're showing a press. Wake Forest is running against it, not showing good patience, taking shots 1-on-3, 1-on-4.
Duke can tie, but Tucker takes it away. Derek McQueen over Hill.
See, Brad, there's a difference there when you're running 3-on-1 as opposed to 1-on-3. That quick shot is a good one. It's 3-on-1. The 1-on-3 quick shot is not.
And Laettner loses the handle on the other end. under Grant Hill is what I tried to say. There you see it.
When you're the first guy down the court and you have that little bit of an advantage, it's a good job to take advantage.
Childress now brings it up against Hurley.
Hurley playing pretty good defense and talking to the official all at the same time.
Childress kind of using that left arm to ward off Hurley's defense. You better watch that. We're down to 5.5 minutes to go in the ball game. 68-64 Wake Forest trying to pull an upset. Siler almost lost it. Childress gets it back, leaves it for Rogers, and Laettner had to foul it. That's three on Christian Laettner.
I thought Siler was going to lose the ball out of bounds, and then that ball's passed. Childress passes it between Laettner's legs right there. He was juggling the ball. That's a great pass.
Rogers will go to the free throw line. He has not been the kind of offensive force that he had been in past games. Only 6 points.
Nothing is more irritating when one of those guards passes it between your legs.
Rogers can't deliver from the line.
Unless it's the center hitting you in the jaw.
Yeah, that'll do it. Rogers, a 6'7 freshman from Durham.
Brad, you talked about Wake Forest in the free throw line. They really need to make these free ones to hold a lead.
Doesn't get either one, but Tucker's there. He's been there all day. Siler. Robert Siler makes it a 6-point ball game again. Davis got bumped by Rogers, no call, and Tucker another rebound.
Tucker jogging up the court. He needs a little blow, and he's taking it on offense.
Had his best game of the year, one of the best of his career. 23 points and 11 rebounds right now for Tucker.
Kubek and King really going at it.
King wheels on Kubek and kicks it back to Siler. Scramble for the ball. Nice hustle by Hurley and Hill. Jump ball possession. Still Wake Forest. Hill and Hurley doing all they can, but you see the arrow goes the Demon Deacons' way. McCaffrey will check back in for Duke. So will Grant Hill. Kubek and Thomas Hill come out. 4:32 remaining, and Wake Forest with a lead. They have led throughout the game. They were up by 4 at halftime, spread it out to a 9-point margin at 60-51. And now up by 6. 4.5 minutes to go. Childress is fouled.
Start to press a little bit defensively, Brad, at this point in the ball game. You know you need some defensive pressure. That time Davis had a pretty good double team, but a little too physical draws the foul.
Well, this is a guy that can shoot free throws. Hasn't shot one today yet, though. I was hoping he wasn't going to do it with his shirt over his eyes there for a second. 80% from the line for the 6'2 freshman from Clinton, Maryland. And he misses, too. It's going to cost Wake in the end if they don't start to hit him.
They've had the answer in other areas, though, Brad, and they've got to hope that trend continues. They continue to do a real fine job in the half-court defense. Now we're going to get a foul against Tucker, trying to guard Davis on the inside.
Tucker picks up his second foul.
McCaffrey's going to set the screen. Really misses Tucker, but the screen's enough that Tucker's off balance, and he just leans into Davis, commits the foul. Now, while Wake Forest has not been able to increase the lead from the free throw line, we'll see if Duke, this time in the person of Brian Davis, can cut into the margin from the line.
Siler goes up. He has 11 points on the day.
He just hit a couple of big baskets on his most recent tour of duty.
4 Wake players in double figures so far. Wake Forest has hit only 50% of their free throws, while Duke has countered with 17 out of 19.
They've scored 9 more points from the free throw line.
There you see what we just talked about. Davis has hit 3 straight. Four in a row for Bryant. Six this half and eight for the ball game for him.
Here is the press again by Duke, and they force a turnover this time.
Chris King changed his pivot feet, trying to find a little bit of room there.
His teammate sort of ran away from him, Brad.
Didn't have a lot of help, did he?
See Mike Krzyzewski over on the bench trying to help everybody out, I think particularly Lenny Wirtz.
Nice job by Childress, but McCaffrey gets it back on the bounce, but he threw it away. Rogers, McQueen, partially blocked. Chris King back to Rogers. Whoa, look out. Major league foul on Brian Davis. Got up in the air and over the top of Rogers. No problem, just a pat on the backside. That was nothing intentional.
Got to be very frustrating for Mike Krzyzewski. His team looked like they were ready to cut it to two, but there's the steal. Look how quickly Wake down the court. There's four guys there, and as a result, the Duke defense never gets set. Maybe there was a little bit for Christian Laettner in there. He really got popped.
He missed his last two free throws. Rogers with 6 points. There, he got that one. 5-point game. Rodney Rogers. Can put Wake back in front by six with under 4 minutes to go if he hits this one. Anthony Tucker, another rebound. He's got 12.
That's two times in the last few trips that Wake has missed from the line, and there's another foul.
McCaffrey fouls Childress, who is going to the hoop.
But Wake Forest has missed from the free throw line, Brad, and then got the rebound off the miss. That's just a back-breaking kind of play for a defense.
Like you said, they're not dropping the free throws, but they're making up for it in other areas. And that's one of them. McCaffrey comes out with four fouls. Thomas Hill comes back in.
They are making up for it in other areas, Brad, but that's the kind of thing that makes a coach gray long before his time. Dave Odom, get a look at right there, I think would just prefer to see those free throws go in the basket.
Still not going in. Childress has missed his last two.
And you wonder if this freshman who has played so well, Brad, is going to think about those two misses.
Finally, one goes for him. 11 points for Childress and a 5-point lead for Wake Forest. Back after this from our friends at Bud Light. Our Pizza Hut game summary. Turnovers. We talked about it when we opened up the show today. Dan, and you said turnovers would be a story. And when's the last time you saw Duke have 19?
Well, they don't turn it over 19 times very often, but Wake Forest has really done a nice job. They've scored 18 points off those turnovers. And there's the other thing. Duke has not gotten a very balanced scoring attack. Laettner with 29 points, nobody else in double figures. And this is a Duke team that has five guys averaging in double figures. Again, though, a guy like Davis or Thomas Hill, he scores a lot of his points in that transition kind of game off the turnover, and since Wake Forest just hasn't given it up that much, Duke has been forced into the half-court game.
Meanwhile, Wake Forest has four players in double figures, and McQueen has 9 points.
Man-to-man defense for the Deacons.
Hill to Laettner. Foul by Chris King. And King now with four fouls.
Well, I'll tell you what, one thing the Duke Blue Devils do not have in trying to get the ball to Laettner is the element of surprise.
That's true.
So they're doing a nice job getting it in there. Everybody in the arena knows that's where they're going to try to put the ball, and the fact that they can get it in his hands says something about their offensive execution.
Christian Laettner going for a 30-point ball game. Didn't get it that time. His high of the season, 37, came against North Carolina Charlotte. He has not gone over the 30-point mark since.
Dave Odom is going to wear a trench in front of the Wake Forest bench with all the pacing he's doing over there.
Both of them came out on Christian Laettner. Miller slows it up. First time today we've said that. Tucker, foul by Hill.
Wake Forest did an excellent job breaking down the Duke defense. They spread the defense out, and then Childress is able to get to the basket very effectively.
Mike Krzyzewski's team has won 7 in a row, 12 of their last 13. That is very much in jeopardy against the Demon Deacon squad that's won 6 of its last 7. They lost to North Carolina Wednesday on the road, but what a week they had last week with wins over Georgia Tech and Virginia. And I said during that Virginia game, although Dave Odom wouldn't admit it to us, Dan, that this whole program has hit a turning point for Wake Forest. I think it is. He would like to deny it and keep it quiet for a while.
Coaches are always working to lower those expectations, Brad.
That's right. 25 for Anthony Tucker. 8-point Wake Forest lead. Grant Hill. Thomas Hill the rebound.
Two on one.
Siler again slows it. Childress to Tucker. Tucker foul on the baseline.
That foul, if it's against Laettner, that's number 4 on Laettner. I think it's against Grant Hill, though.
That'll be 4 on Hill.
Foul was called against Hill. You're right, Brad.
Tucker goes to the free throw line, where he has hit 7 in a row from the stripe. 7 of 9 on the day. 25-point outing. By far his best game of the year, Anthony Tucker. In fact, a career high now for Anthony Tucker. Transferred from Georgetown. He's played point guard. He's played the two guard spot. He's been a forward. He has had a career day this afternoon at home. He'll remember this one regardless of the outcome. 2:45 to play. Laettner, 3-pointer. Hill, the offensive rebound, and he's fouled.
Last two Duke possessions have resulted in Thomas Hill off. He scored, this time he gets fouled.
A lot of folks looking at extinction here. Davis and Hill for Duke, King and Medlin with 4. Rogers and McQueen, Laettner, Thomas Hill. Duke has had the better of it from the free throw line so far today.
Duke's missed a couple in a row. That's 3 in a row. Laettner missed 2. Now Hill misses 1.
...76-69. 7-point Wake Forest lead, and pressure all over the place by the Blue Devils. Siler to Rogers. Laettner short, McQueen the rebound. 5 rebounds for McQueen to go with his 9 points. And very few of any turnovers by McQueen today. Tucker double teamed, in trouble. Almost threw it away, got it back and laid it in. Hurley way outside. Bobby Hurley with 2 field goals today. Both are 3-pointers. That one comes with 1:52 to go. This put Wake Forest up by 10 points. Hurley came back and quieted the crowd, but this had him excited. Wake Forest, 8-point lead. 1:52 to go.
ACC Basketball has been brought to you by U.S. Air, Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company, Central Fidelity, Bud Light, Buick, and by Food Lion.
Accommodations provided by Hilton. We've invested over $1 billion to raise the standard of what a great hotel should be, and that's just the beginning. Hilton, it's all in the name.
Mike Krzyzewski's team looking at a 7-game winning streak that might be about set to go down the drain, but we still have 1:52 to play, and that's an eternity with a team like Duke. Wake with an 8-point cushion, and here's the pressure in the backcourt from the Blue Devil. That's a risky pass.
Kubek played that very, very well.
Like a free safety out there.
That's a risky pass, too. Duke's lucky to keep that one.
Hurley tries it again. Oh, what a collision. Kubek and Davis collide.
Kubek's really hurt.
Seiler out to McQueen. Now they're going to whistle things dead. That was a major league collision between teammates Brian Davis and Greg Kubek.
They're going after the basketball. Looks like he got hit almost in the neck. Looks like the neck and the shoulder.
Been just your basic non-contact sport again today. 128 to play, 80-72, Wake Forest. Tucker will call a timeout, unable to get the ball in. Maybe the only thing all day that Dave Odom hasn't liked about Anthony Tucker's game. Timeout. 128 to go and an 8-point Wake Forest lead. We'll be back. Wake Forest will try it again as Tucker again, the trigger man on the inbound, and got it into Childress this time. As a triple team on Childress and a foul on Thomas Hill. Four on Thomas Hill.
Brad trailing by 8 points with only a minute and 24 seconds left in the basketball game. Mike Krzyzewski's team doesn't have many options left. You play the tough defense against the inbounds pass. If you do not get the immediate steal, then you've got to foul somebody. Childress, even though he's a very good free throw shooter percentage-wise on the year, has struggled today, so maybe he's not a bad guy to foul.
Two free throws the rest of the way, though, as Duke's over the 10-foul limit.
And then again, maybe he is.
That's 12 for Childress, the reigning ACC Player of the Week for what he did in upset wins over Georgia Tech and Virginia. This will be one that will go in the record book as an upset of more magnitude if it holds.
Wake Forest can hang on, Brad. I just think this is a huge win for them.
This gets them in the NCAA, doesn't it?
Of course, you got a long way to go, and they could fall apart, but barring a complete collapse, I think you're right. Laettner's going to get that foul.
And we'll walk it down on the other end as Laettner picks up his fourth.
And the other thing for Duke is you got to shoot the three, and if you don't get it, you've got to go hard after the basketball. That's not actually a very bad foul. In fact, it's a good foul because you stop the game right away.
Childress back to the line. He's hit his last three after missing a couple.
Brad, we were talking about Wake Forest and what this victory means. They play at Maryland and they have Clemson at home, and those are no cinch victories, but they are the two bottom teams in the conference. Then they play New Hampshire at home, then they go to NC State. So I would say that that schedule very much in favor of the Deacons and the NCAA tournament if they can hang on here.
An 11-point lead matches the largest of the day. Cut to 8 again by Hill. Thomas Hill with his second three of the afternoon. A timeout with 103 to go. It is 83-75.
Well, that's an option that Duke is running out of now. If you're going to score and call timeouts, you're going to have to cut into that 8-point lead. Doesn't help you very much to trade baskets with Wake Forest now.
You and I will be in Durham on Wednesday night for Duke and North Carolina State, and I very much thought that that would be a rematch for Duke, having been the last team that has beaten them was North Carolina State, but I think that's going to change today. So it's North Carolina State at home for Duke, then at Arizona. That's a real day at the beach. Arizona's won about, what, 65 games on their home floor or something like that. Clemson, and then at North Carolina on a Sunday to end the regular season. So it's not an easy go for Duke. They've got one timeout left. Some people asked us before the game, hey, can Duke beat UNLV? And we all decided that maybe the Portland Trailblazers, the Lakers, the Bulls, the Pistons, a few of those teams can beat UNLV. I mentioned that to Jay Billis and Tommy Amaker, assistant coaches for Duke. They both said, hey, let us get through the ACC season before we even think about worrying about those guys. And indeed, they have hit a major roadblock here in Winston-Salem today. This will mean there'll be a knot in the top spot in the ACC standings. And we looked at 63 seconds goes as planned for Dave Odom.
We looked at the Duke schedule. They've got three conference games remaining. Two of them are at home, and they're going to have to beat NC State and Clemson at home to set up that showdown with North Carolina that may be for the league championship and the bye in the tournament.
Trying to foul McQueen. Hurley couldn't get the foul.
Hurley's been complaining all day when he's called for fouls. Now he complains when he doesn't get called.
Finally, they whistle it. And Wake Forest got to use about 9 seconds before the foul was finally called. So with 52 seconds left, McQueen will go to the line with the Deacons in front, 83-75. About a third of the fans in this building haven't taken a seat except maybe for halftime since about the 5 minute mark of the first half.
I'll tell you what, somebody who hasn't taken a seat all day is Dave Odom. Free throw goes in. As you look at that Wake Forest bench, even if he wanted to, there's no space for him to sit down.
That's
over
right
there. There's no empty seats.
Now five Wake Forest players in double figures as McQueen has 10 to go with his 6 rebounds for the little guy. Only 3 turnovers from his point guard spot. Missed the second. Davis got the rebound.
Come down looking for the quick three. Wake obviously has to defend the perimeter.
Hurley way outside is short. McCaffrey set up better for his. He doesn't get it either. Rogers pulls down the rebound. 3 on, make it 4 on 1. And McQueen wisely going to use a little clock. But he threw it away. And Davis goes the other way. That's the last Duke timeout with 22 seconds to go.
Good decision by Siler to just let that play happen. If you're Dave Odom, you're watching Siler run after Davis down the court. You're always afraid as to what he's going to do, but Siler pulling off and letting him score.
3-point play they didn't need there. It is a 7-point game. Duke's out of timeouts. The possession arrow is Duke's, by the way. If Wake Forest holds on, we'll have a tie for the top spot in the ACC at 8-3, and Wake Forest will move into the 6-5 spot there with Virginia, North Carolina State mixed in. Georgia Tech has really been struggling, and they're at 5-6. Maryland 3-8, Clemson 1-9.
As we said, considering Wake Forest's remaining schedule, their games include a home date with Clemson, a road date with Maryland, and a road date with NC State.
The reason NC State didn't have the same number of games, they're playing non-conference. We showed you a partial score earlier. They're playing Connecticut. So their ACC standing will not change today. Wake Forest brings out Siler, McQueen, Rogers, Tucker, and Childress. Duke counters with McCaffrey, Davis, Thomas Hill, Christian Laettner, and Bobby Hurley. We've got 22 seconds left. And a 7-point Wake Forest lead. On the way, and Laettner knocks it away. That used a second.
That was a fast second.
About the only thing Wake Forest had trouble with is inbounding the ball today. They'll try to foul Childress, but he got around the traffic. Maybe they won't get a chance to foul it. Nice pass to Siler. McQueen goes into a dribbling act. Tucker! And Wake's got their biggest win of the year. Just just a little bit happy in Winston-Salem. 86-77. Wake Forest is shock number five, Duke, here at Joel Coliseum this afternoon. Our players of the game. That man, Anthony Tucker, for Wake Forest, who had a career afternoon. 31 points, 11 rebounds, 4 assists, and 3 steals. Christian Laettner was really the only answer Duke had, and it wasn't enough. Our NCNB players of the game, Anthony Tucker, and is he a happy young man?